Hello my dear student, welcome to Nagesh Karasgi Orchid School channel. Myself Hina Patel, going to teach you 7th grade mathematics. In the previous class, we had learned about the comparing quantity. We will learn some more example related to it. We had tried to solve the fraction to the percent, decimal to the percent. Today we will learn about the whole quantity. So how to convert into and percent if the quantities are given. We will have some example related to here. We are having find the whole quantities if 5% of x is equal to 600. 5% of x is equal to 600. Here x is a variable, so we have to find out the value of x. Let the required whole quantity be the x. We required a whole quantity. The question is equal, is itself says whole quantity. So whatever we required, let be it a x which is given in our question. So 5% is written as 5/100 multiplied by of means it is multiplication by x is equal to 600. Now you know x is equal to 600 multiplied by 100/5. What we had done, just when it is in the LHS, when it comes into RHS, that is left hand side to right hand side, it will be reciprocal because it is in the form of a division, or we can say it is in the form of a fraction. So it will be 100/5. Now try to reduce it. So after reduction, we get as an 12,000. So 5% of x, the quantity, whole quantity is nothing but an 12,000. Thus the required whole quantity is 12,000. Here we will have some more examples, so it will be more easy to understand. Here we are having example as 12% of x. 12% of x is equal to rupees 1080, that is nothing but 1080, which is given in the form of rupees here. So it will be more easy, and it will be more easy to understand also that rupees we use in our daily life. So what we write here is 12% is written as 12/100 of x multiplied by x is equal to rupees 1080, that is 1080. Take x to the left hand side, x is equal to, what is equal to? Rupees 1080 multiplied by 100/12. Again the same, we have to go for a reciprocal. So it will be 100/12. Reduced it to the lowest term, then after reduction we get as a rupees 9000. So what will be thus? The required whole quantity is rupees 9000. So in this way we had find out the percent of x of rupees 1080. Another example is 40% of x is equal to 500. Now my dear student, you can solve yourself, because two example we had solved here, so it is easy to understand the step also. So 40% is written as 40/100 multiplied by x is equal to 500 kilometer. So what we write, x is equal to 500 multiplied by 100/40. After reducing this, it is given in the kilometer, so we have to mention here the unit as an kilometer. After reduction we get as a 1250 kilometer. Thus the required quantity is equal to 1250 kilometer. So in this way we can find out the percentage of the whole quantity. Here it is, one more example is given, 70% of x is equal to 14 minutes. 70% of x is equal to 14 minutes. What we will write? 70/100, which is written in the form of a percent, multiplied by x is equal to 14 minutes. So x is equal to 14 multiplied by 100/70. After the reduction, 0 get cancelled, 7 1s are, 7 2s are, it will be 20 minutes. So thus the required quantity is equal to 20 minutes. In this way we can substitute the value, and step by step you can find out the answer. Again, one example here, it was given minute. In the previous question, we had learned about the kilometer. So here we are having some different units. So it will be more easy to understand here. It is 8% of x is equal to 40 liters. Here 8 upon 100 into x is equal to 40. It is here liter, this is, it is printing mistake. So x is equal to 40 multiplied by 100 upon 8 is equal to 500 liters. So multiplication after reduction we get as an 500 liters. Thus the required quantity is equal to 500 liters. In this way, what we had done, we had find out the quantity, whole quantity. Here we are having one tabular form which will be more easy to understand. Convert the given percent to the decimal form and the fraction, decimal and fraction. So here 25% is given, 150% is given, 20% is given, 50% is given. First, what we have to do, we have to convert in a decimal form. So when it is a percentage, so you know it is out of always 100. So 25 upon 100 is equal to 0.25. So you know when it is divided by 100, you have to take the two digit from the right hand side and it will go to decimal point to the left hand side, that is going backward. Just count the two digit, 1 and 2, give the decimal point. So we write as a 0.25. So this 25% can be written as a 25 upon 100 in a form of a fraction, and if it is reduced, we write as 1 upon 4. We write as 1 upon 4. Here we are having some 2-3 examples here, we will see here. So you can understand when it is given in the percentage, we can write in a decimal form as well as fraction form. So here 150%, percent means always out of 100, so we write as upon 100, which will be written in the decimal form as 1.50, because two digit to the backward side or to the left hand side. So after 1 and 2 digit we will give the decimal, so it will be 1.50. So what will be the fraction? 150 upon 100, reduced it, it will be the lowest term, so it will be 3 upon 2 will be the fraction of this. Here 20% is equal to 20 upon 100, so it will be 0.2. here the fraction will be 20 upon 100. After reduction we get as 1 upon 5. Here in the 5%, 5 upon 100, so 0.05, which will be in the decimal form, when we write in a fraction form is 5 upon 100, which will be after reduction we get as an 1 upon 25. So this we had learned that percentage can be written in the decimal form as well as this can be written in a fraction form. Here we are having some word problem, so we will see that word problem, so it will be understood by you. In a city, 30% are female, 40% are males, and remaining are children. So what percent are children? They had given in the percent, they had not given in the quantities. This type of a sum of additions, that population of a village or population of city is this much are women, this much are men, and find the children, that you had learned in the third or fourth standard. But here we are using a percent. Here the percent of female in the city is 30% females and 40% are male. So we have to find out the total percent of children in a city. So what is given, we will read the question and we will jot down here, is 30% are female, which is given in the question, 40% are males, and the total percent of female and male together is 30% plus 40% is 70%. You know always it is a percentage, means we have to consider out of 100. So therefore the percentage of a children, therefore the percentage of a children is equal to 100 minus 70. What is 70? It is nothing but a total percent of male as well as the total percent of a female is 70%. So 100% minus 70% will be a 30%. So 30% are children in the city. So in this way we had find out, it was very simple example to understand. So number of children in the city, that is given in the percentage form, is 30, because they had not given us in the number form, they had given us in a percentage. So we had find out the answer also in percentage. So we will see one more example here. Out of 15,000 voters in a constituency, 60% voted. Out of 15,000 only, how many? 60% voting is done. Find the percent of voters who did not vote. We have to find out the number of voters which have not voted for the elections or constituency. That number of percent of voter we have to find out. Already we know that 60% have done the voting. Now we have to find out how many people or how many voters have not voted out of 15,000. Out of 15,000. So can you now find how many actually did not vote? How many have not vote, not done the voting? That we have to find out. First, what we'll do, we'll write the solution from the reading the statement. That is, total number of voters are how many? 15,000. You can imagine the your nearby area, that is some colonies or something, that you are having 15,000 of people over there. 60% have done the voting, and what are the number of people who have not done the voting, that we are finding here. So percentage of the voters who voted is 60%, which is already given in the question. So percentage of voters who did not vote is equal to 100 minus 60%. 100 minus 60% is 40% have not done the voting. So this we got in a percentage, but we should know that how many people have done, because we were having a 15,000 voters. So we will try to find out that out of this 40%, out of this, how many have not voted is 40%. So actual number of voters who did not vote is 40% of 15,000. Out of 15,000, how many people have not voted is 40% of people. We don't know the quantity, we know the in a percent. So this percent, you know very well how to convert this percent. 40% of 15,000, we had seen various example. Same steps you have to follow. 40 upon 100 multiplied by 15,000. After reduction, we will get as in 6,000. So 6,000 people have not voted, or we can say 6,000 voter have not done the voting out of 15,000 voters. In this way, we have find out the number of people or not voted for the constituency. Now another example is very easy one. Here the Meera saves rupees 400 from her salary. Meera saves rupees 400 from her salary. If this is a 10% of her salary, what her salary is? What is her salary? Out of that she saves 400 rupees, and if it is a 10% of her salary, what will be the Meera salary? So let Meera salary be X. We don't know, we have to find out the what will be the Meera salary. So we are considering as an X. Let Meera salary be X. Now what percentage salary she is saving is 10%. So 10% of X is equal to how much? Is 400. 10% of X is equal to 400. Now if you get this statement, you can solve the value of X is nothing but it is a salary of an Meena, which is she get in a her hand, and out of that Meena, she is saving 400 rupees from her salary. That is nothing but it is a 10% of her salary. So 10% of x is equal to 400. So how you write 10% is 10 upon 100 into x is equal to rupees 400. So x is equal to 400 multiplied by 100 upon 10. You know this, it will be a reciprocal because it will transpose, or we can say it is LHS to RHS. So after reducing this, we get as an rupees 4000. Thus the Meena's salary is rupees 4000 rupees. What is her salary? Is 4000. Out of that she is saving 10%, that is nothing but rupees 400 she is saving per month. So we had found out the salary, and what was given to us was a percentage of salary she was saving, that is 400. Now similar example here, a local cricket team played 20 matches in one season. In one season they play 20 matches. It won 25 out of them. Out of these 20 matches, they had won 25% of them. How many matches did they win? They had win how many? 25% of these matches. How many matches were that? 20 matches were played in a one season. So number of matches played by the cricket team is equal to 20. Already it is given in the question, is 20. The percentage of matches won by the team is given as then 25%. So that is nothing but a 25% is written as 25 upon 100 multiplied by 20. So after reducing, we can find that is 5 matches. Thus the number of matches won by them is how many? Out is 5, because they had won only 25 matches. 25% of the matches, total matches were 20 matches. So out of 20 matches, how many they had won? They had won 5 matches, because it is given in the percentage, 25% of matches. So in this way we had tried to solve some word problem. Also we will see some new relationships between ratios to percent. We will have some example, then we will go through and exercise some. Here ratio to percent. So sometimes the part are given to us in the form of ratios, and we need to convert them to a percentage. Consider the following examples. Here Reena's mother said, to make idlis you must take two parts of rice and one part of urad dal. To make a idli, her mother has given a one ratio that she should take two parts of rice and one part of urad dal. What percentage of such a mixture would be a rice, and what percentage would be the urad dal? Now ratio was given, we have to find out a percentage of the urad dal as well as the rice. So in term of ratio, we write as given the rice is to urad dal. Rice is given two part of rice and urad dal is a one part. So 2:1 is a ratio. Now 2+1 is equal to how much? 3. What we had done? We had just added 2+1 as to ratio, that is 2+1 is 3, is the total part. This means that 2/3 part of rice and 1/3 part of an urad dal. This is nothing but, because here the denominators are same, we are 2/3 part of rice and 1/3 part of urad dal. So then percentage of rice would be, what we had done, first we had written 2/3 we are considering as rice, and what is our total ratio is 3. So 2 upon 3 I am taking here. First to find out the percentage of rice. And afterward 1 upon 3, that is 1 I am having here as a ratio of urad dal, and total is 3. So 1 upon 3 part of an urad dal. Then I will find out the percent of an urad dal. So one by one we will find out what percent of a rice would be, that is 2 upon 3 multiplied by 100%. Because already we had read the question, if they want in a percentage of urad dal as well as a rice. So multiplied by 100%, you know now very well, if it is possible we have to reduce. If it is not possible, just write a fraction, and after getting an improper fraction we have to divide and we have to write in a mixed fraction. Here we are having an improper fraction, so after division we are getting as a mixed fraction as 66 whole 2 upon 3%. Now percentage of urad dal would be 1 upon 3 multiplied by 100% is nothing but 100 upon 3. Here the same scenario, here also we have a improper fraction, so we have to convert into a mixed fraction. After the division we get as 33 whole 1 upon 3%. When you add this both, that is nothing but it is an 100%. So here in this way we had find out the percentage of a rice as well as urad dal required when it was given in the form of an ratio. First what we had done, we had written the ratio, then we had find out it into and percentage. So we will see some more examples, so it will be more easy for you to understand. Here one more example we are having. Here is, if rupees 250 is to be divided among the Ravi and Raju and Roy, 250 rupees to be divided to the three student or three children, we can say it is, one is Ravi, Raju and Roy, so that Ravi get 2 parts, Raju 3 parts and the Roy 5 parts. How much money will each get? What will it be in a percentage? First we have to see what will be the amount each will get, and then we have to see in percentage. So what will be the percentage of money they will get out of 250 rupees? So we will first find out the amount. The amount received by each one of these, one is Ravi, Raju and Roy. So one by one we will solve. Here is given of Ravi, Raju and Roy. But first what we had in the previous question, first we will write the ratio and we will do the sum of this all the parts, that is nothing but the total of the part, that is the parts which the three boys are getting can be written in the term of, it is given as 2 part by Ravi, 3 part by Raju and 5 part by Roy. So 2 is to 3 is to 5. So total or sum of these parts is 2 plus 3 plus 5 is equal to 10. 2 plus 3 plus 5 is equal to 10. So what is this total part? So out of this 250, they have two total parts, is we have to divide is 10. So what we will do, one by one we will solve. First we will see about Ravi. What is the Ravi getting? A part is 2 parts of the 250 he is getting. So 2 upon 10. What is 10? Is nothing but an total parts. 2 upon 10 multiplied by rupees 250. Here 0 get cancelled. 0 get cancelled is 25. 2za is rupees 50. Now we will see of Raju is 3 upon 10. So 3 upon 10 multiplied by rupees 250, again this is a part of Raju is going to get, is a 3 part, and we know the total part by adding here, it is a 10. So we write as out of 10 the Raju is getting how many part? He is getting only 3 parts. So 3 upon 10, which is written in the fraction form, multiplied by 250 is equal to, after reduction we get as 25, 3 za is 75. So rupees 75. Here Roy having getting of 5 parts out of 250, but here total parts are how many? It's 10. So 5 upon 10 multiplied by 250 is equal to rupees 125. So possible to reduce, we had reduced 25, 5 size 125. So we got to know that out of 250 rupees, the parts they are going to get, which is given in the question, we had tried to solve it. So Ravi will get 50 rupees, Raju will get 75 rupees, and Roy will get 125 rupees. Now our question is not completed, they want it in a percentage. So again we have to find out in a percentage, the percentage of a money for each. Now you know Ravi gets 2 upon 10th part. Here already we had find out here what is the part received by the Ravi is 2 parts. So we write as then 2 upon 10 multiplied by 100%, it's out of 100. So we multiply it by 100%, after reduction we can say this 0 get cancelled, 10 2s are 20%. Out of 100%, the 20% of amount is got by Ravi. What about the Raju? Raju is having 3 upon 10 parts multiplied by 100%, after cancelling this 0, 0 we get a 30% will be the Raju, and Roy will be the 50%. When you do the sum of this all the percent, it should be 100 because it's a out of 100%. So in this way we were having two questions in this word problem. First we had find out the amount of money they are getting per person, that is Ravi, Raju and Roy, and what is the amount and the percentage of money they are getting. We had find out in the step by step. First we had done the total parts, which was given in the form of a ratio as an part which was get by Ravi, Raju and Roy. So hope so my dear student you have understood this step by step. You have to just solve, read the problem and try to solve the, find out the solution for the problem. So in this way we had learned about this. Now increase or decrease as a percent, increase or decrease as a percent. Now there are times when we need to know the increase or decrease in the certain quantities as an percentage. For example, if the population of a state increased from 5 lakhs 50,000 to and 6 lakhs 5,000, then the increase in the population can be understood better if we say that the population increased by a 10%. The population was increased by 10%, that will be more easy to understand. So increase or decrease as percent, here was example is given up regarding the population. So we will see here that increase by 10%, the population was given, first it was 5 lakhs 50,000, what to it is increased to 6 lakhs 5,000. So increase in 10%. So how do we convert the increase or decrease in a quantities as a percentage of an initial amount? Consider the following example. We will see this example so you can understand how to find out increase in a percent. A school team won 6 games this year against 4 games won last year. What is the percent increase? They had given comparison of last year and this year. By what percent is increased or won by the student of the team? So the increase in the number of wins, or we can say the amount of change, that is increase or decrease, already I told, is equal to 6 minus 4, that is 6 games in this year against 4 games won in the last year. So 6 minus 4 is equal to 2. So percentage increase is equal to amount of change upon the original amount or the base. What is original amount or the base? Multiplied by 100, because we have to find in percentage. So increase in the number of beans is 6 and is 2, and then original number of beans is 6 here. So we can say multiplied by 100, so we will get as 2 upon 4. So what is it? Increase in the number of beans, here it is increased. We had find out here is 2, and how many was original number of beans? Here it is already given as of 4 games they had won. How many they had won? 4. So what we write as 2 upon 4 multiplied by 100. So after the reduction, 4 ones are 4, 25 is are, so 25 twos are is 50. So in this way we can say that percentage of increase is 50%. So what we had done, just we had written that increase in the number of wins, that we had find out the difference. Here was 6 games was won, games were played in the last, in this year and the last year, 4 games was won by them. So we had taken the difference here is a 2. So my dear student, you have understood this word problem, that increase or decrease in the percentage. Similarly, you can create your own example, and you can find out by taking some other games, and you can find out the percent of increase or decrease. In this way, if you create your own example, it will be more easy to understand. So hope so, my dear student, you have understood. Thank you very much.